The following program is dedicated to generations of mid-Michigan families who recognize WKRTV as an essential community resource through their continued financial support.
Well, I think too many people forgot the past.
If you're happy and you have a good time when you're a child, you're going to remember it.
Life was simple those days.
Those were the days, of course, when little girls wore hats and ladies did too, and white gloves when they went out.
I think it's a part of human nature. I think everybody is nostalgic.
I think one of the things in everybody's life is they got to know of what other people have experienced.
I'm willing to share what I remember because I know it was great.
As an individual, you have these memories and you kind of want them to be continued. You don't want people to forget about it because it was so special.
Had kinds of fun shops that we enjoyed going to. We could actually walk there if we needed to.
Downtown was downtown. Downtown was a place that you could go and enjoy yourself.
Everything was downtown. The theaters were downtown. The professions were downtown. The physicians, the dentists, the insurance offices, real estate offices, the attorneys were all there, as well as the retail stores. So it was a very active community both day and
evening. On Saturdays, especially shopping days, everybody went downtown. There's people all around everywhere.
Every time we would go downtown, there would be hundreds and hundreds, probably thousands of people milling the streets, walking in from shop to shop. Downtown was where it was, where it was happening.
Always Saturday was the big shopping day, not for just us, but everyone shopped on Saturday. My sister and I would always save our money on Saturday. We could go downtown and go shopping. We'd get to go shopping at Neisner's and Jupiter's or Kresge's or Grant's or some of those, you know, and just spent the whole day buying all our bargains we could find. Saturday morning, I'd go by myself doing my shopping while my husband take care of my children. And I will go and have breakfast downtown in a restaurant that was right on the corner, and it was set at dinner.
Get into the Broadway, having a Coney Island hot dog at the Broadway.
And they serve it with onions and mustard, and we used to go there a lot to get those big Coney dogs.
There's so many of those little restaurants in downtown that are all unique in their own little way.
Mostly, we went to the home dairy because almost all the shopping for the food was done there.
People would shop there, do their grocery shopping, and take it home no matter where they lived.
Some of the things that you couldn't find at just a plain market could go to home dairy, and they would have them.
We used to have meetings upstairs. They had a meeting room that they allowed the community to meet in.
And then they had a cafeteria upstairs.
The home dairy was a place where everybody went.
People used to line up there to wait their turn to get after school at the counter there.
We were terribly busy. The people were four or five deep waiting at the counter to be waited on.
I guess liking sweets as much as I do, I think that's the part that probably sticks in my mind, are the goodies that they had.
Mostly, we went to those places where kids congregate. In those days, it was Walgreens or Rouser's.
Rouser's, another wonderful place. And it's still, I just love that building.
I hope they never tear it down. They had a great soda fountain and served lunches. And for a quarter, you could go in and get a very nice lunch. You also could get a prescription filled.
Kewpie's made the best burgers in town.
Everybody went to Kewpie's. A little bright metal building there.
They were in the middle of the 100 block on Shiawassee.
It was a very popular spot for all of the young people.
Cars would be lined up way into Washington Avenue.
My favorite place that's no longer downtown would be the old Tap Lounge, the little hole in the wall. The fun that was generated out of there was magnificent.
There was a store called St. Susan's, and I loved that store because it was expensive.
I like to go to Style Shop for better quality clothing.
Style Shop.
I'd go there on my lunch hour and always had things in layaway. I'd pay a little on them every week. They got all my money.
I like to go into Lansing Dry Goods. I love to go in there and just listen. They put their money in little silver things, and they go all the way across the store and up, and I'd just stand there watching and listen to the bells ringing, and it was just everybody was bustling around. It was just a happy place.
They didn't have the cashiers. The cashiers sat up on the mezzanine, and they had those pneumatic tubes that they would put in the slot, and they would be skirting all around the store with those pneumatic tubes, and then they would come back with the change in them, and you would hear a cling, ding, as they would be transported.
You would see many people who were just making it, would be in Kings buying the clothes. And when you'd be out in company with them, you'd say, yeah, I got my coat in Kings, I got my suit in Kings. It was a letter, a name that we identified in our community. I speak in our community, in the primary minority community.
My favorite place is not there anymore. We have two log views. It had the big pictured window, and everybody could just walk past and see you. And we would love to sit right in front of the window so we could see everybody that goes past and knock on the window with people. Here I am. It's fun.
The Penny's building. They had an escalator there. I remember someone telling me it was the first escalator in the United States. I don't know if I believe it or not, but it was sure archaic compared to the escalators now. But it was great, and it was something special. And I remember my mother taking me down to the Penny's building specifically to ride the escalator. And that was kind of neat.
The good things that I remember is just being able to window shop.
Go downtown and do window shopping on Sunday nights. You know, all the stores they had displays and they changed them regularly. When you're downtown,
you'll find a place for sure. It was a place when you started out in the middle of the town and start walking down Washington Avenue. It was exciting to start at the very end of town and walk all the way through it, because there was something going on everywhere, and it was busy, and people were laughing, and I think it was just awesome, really.